G'day, this video is part 1 of 3 for making your first colour-coded working diagram utilising Lace 8. If you want to follow along, you will need to download colourcoded.lc8 and veryfirst.lc8 from the file section of the Facebook users group Lace 8 users. Now open Lace 8 and both of those files. To preserve the original file, let's make a copy and name it Very First ICC. So File, Save as a Lace 8 Design. Navigate to where you want to save it and name it Very First ICC. Now we go to the Home tab and work on the layers. By working on different layers, each element is separated in our lace and we can copy, delete, change, move, just that element. So let's go on here. Using the layers drop down, let's lock the two layers that have got something in them already. So we will lock layer 1 and layer 3. We will rename layer 4 ground ICC. Actually, let's do that in reverse. We will rename layer 4 ICC ground, layer 5 ICC footside, layer 6 ICC spider, 7 becomes, and you're getting the gist here, ICC fan, and last of course will be our trail, so that's ICC trail. Click OK, and now here in this section we're going to change to the layer that we're going to do first, which is ground, layer 4, and go to Drawing Tools. Go to Color Code, select Copy, come back, and paste. Now, in theory, I have got layer 1 and layer 3 locked. And I should have some numbers now here on layer 4. Lace 8 at the moment isn't playing nice with me, and it's actually dropped that paste in on layer 1. So to fix that, I'm just going to unlock layer 1, go to layer 1, select the design, go to layer 4, and it will ask me, do I want to put that design on layer 4? I say yes. Deselect, and now I go back to layer 1 and lock it before coming back to layer 4. As I said, it's a workaround, and I'm sure it's fixed by the time you see this video, so in which case all you'll need to do is go to Color Code, select Copy, come back, and paste. First of all, we're going to copy the element. Make sure that Snap to Grid is still on, and then we're going to go Paste, and paste in the element, which is the ground, the half stitch ground, into the ground section here. You'll notice that I'm leaving the footside section free because we'll be working on that next. And you'll also notice, deselect, you'll also notice that all of these join up nicely. That's why we're not reinventing the wheel and drawing them in again. Copy them. Paste them into this section. Deselect. Select the one out here and delete him because he's no longer useful. Let's go up here. We're going to lock the ground and leave. We're going to move on to layer 5, which is the foot side. Click OK. Change to layer 5. We're now on layer 5 and we're going to do the foot side. To make this a little bit easy, because we're going to try and join these links up, we're going to zoom in nice and close. I'm going to go up to 500 so it's really clear and easy for you to see. You can do less if you wish. Now, one of the things we need to think about at this point is what stitches we're going to use out here. I've decided that this is going to be a half stitch. It's going to be cloth stitch through the passive, and then it's going to be cloth stitch with a twist at the edge. So the colours will be green, purple, and red. To start off, I'm going to do my greens first. So I need to go up to options, default colours and widths, and make sure that my smooth curve is green and it is size 2. Click on save. Make sure snap to grid is turned off now. Go to our first point. Nothing happened because I hadn't chose smooth curve. Go to our first point. And I've got mine set so that I click manually where I want the curve to be. I'll just show you that in the options. Under preferences, under curve drawing, I've got manual here. And I've got show curve nodes on. You can have those turned off if you wish. I find them easier for me to work with. So rather than reinvent the wheel and redo that all these times, turn on snap to grid, select it, copy, and paste it down. Scroll down a little bit, get those last few in, go back up to where we started. As you can see, that's nice and easy, clear, precise. The next section I'm going to do is the red on the outside. So again, it's smooth curves, but now I need to change the colour. Options, default colours and widths, smooth curve, red. And red is for cloth stitch with a twist or cross twist, cross twist. So we're going to start here. Now you notice nothing happened or it gave me a long line. That's because I have got snap to grid turned on, turn it off, and we've got more control again. Now remembering that the invisible line is running from this side to that side, so about the joining point, remembering the thread goes down to this one, and then in, right mouse click to stop it. I'm not too pleased with the way that curve there hasn't got enough swirl to it, so I'll undo and do it again with a couple more clicks. Starting from there, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then drop down. Again, don't reinvent the wheel. Copy and paste is a wonderful invention. Oops, sorry. Copy. Snap to grid. And now I'm choosing snap to grid at this point so that we can copy it close around the next lots of dots. So we go paste now. Nice and neat. And that's why the first one needs to be as neat as possible, because that's the one you're going to be copying and pasting further down. There we go. Go back up to the top now and choose, we're going to do the centerpiece, which is cloth stitch across the passive. So we need to change the colour again, default colours and widths. But this time, because we're going to do a straight line, it's actually the gimp we're going to do, and we'll change that to purple and make sure gimp says 2 width. Save. Now we're going to go from that point up. Don't forget to turn off snap to grid. We're going from this point and turn on straight gimp. Go from this point towards there, but back a little bit because we don't need to go around that curve, and put in the mark. Just being a little bit pedantic here, I'm just going to drag that down until it joins the red. Go back to straight gimp and do the next one. To there. Not really happy with that first one. I think it's going a bit too close to that line, to the dot, so I'll just drag it down a fraction. There we go. Now again, we can reinvent the wheel, but copy and paste is a wonderful invention. So I'm just going to circle around the two that I've done there. Copy, snap to grid. Scroll down a bit so I can see the next few sections. Paste, and paste them in. I think that might be the last one, but I'll just double check that. No, it wasn't. There we go. All we have left to do now is the green around here and the passive. So let's go back and do the green, default colors and widths, smooth curve green. Make sure it's still 2, click it, save. Turn off snap to grid. Turn on smooth curve. Draw in your green curve around the pinhole. Make it nice and smooth. Select it. Now if you have trouble selecting the corners, try selecting it on the curve. Go copy, snap to grid, and now we can paste them in. The last thing left to do is the passive. So I'm just going to scroll out a bit so I can see it all in one go. It's going to be a straight gimp, but it needs to be purple. So let's go back to options, default colors and widths. Straight gimp is purple, size 2, perfect. Do it again. Make it as straight as you can, lift your finger up and it's all done. Now to give you an idea how this looks without the background behind it, we're just going to turn those off. So let's go into home, drop down, make invisible those ones. And you'll notice the one thing is missing is we've got no dots through our foot side, so we need to put those in. Now just a couple more things to finish off the foot side. We need to just neaten this up here so that anybody looking at it can understand what's going on. First of all, let's go to item select and select the purple that goes across there. That one. Copy and paste. Undo select a grid. Smooth curve and red, so let's just make sure it's still red. No, it's green, so let's make it red. Smooth curve. And then just put that little curve in there. That's nice and easy for anybody looking at it to understand what goes where. While we're at it, we can do this end here. So again, item select, copy, snap to grid, paste, deselect, undo snap to grid, and draw in that last smooth curve. Now let's have a look at this. Looking good. All right, now we're moving on to the next one, which is the spiders.